My name is Dimitry Berenson. I'm an assistant professor here in electrical and computer engineering, and I'm also part of the Robotics Institute. So right now we're in the ARM lab, the Autonomous Robotic Manipulation Lab, and here what we study are algorithms that can make robots interact with the world autonomously. Here we have Dale McConaughey, who is working on the manipulation and robot execution part of the framework.
Any comment?
And over here we have Vinay Pilania, who is working on doing the planning for figuring out which objects to pick up in
five,
which order.
5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, there we go.
So the robot here is doing a task where it has to dig through a pile of objects to get to a certain desired object.
Just in case.
The other beanbags we want to kind of get out of the way, get rid of them so we can get to the red one and grasp it reliably. Perceiving what beanbags are overlapping what other ones is not easy, and sequencing the right amount of actions to get to the red beanbag efficiently is also not easy because we have to think about the relationships between the different beanbags. Now, of course, in the real world, we wouldn't be sorting beanbags. This would be a robot that was maybe digging through a bin of parts to get the right part for assembly process, or you could even think of a domestic robot in the home digging through a bin of toys to get the toy that the child requested. But I see robots becoming more and more useful in our daily lives, automating some of these dirty, dumb, and dangerous tasks that humans either can't do or don't want to do. It turns out that people build very expensive machines just to sort parts out and to get them into known places and so on. So if you could make a robot arm that was able to do that autonomously without these big expensive machines, then it would be much more efficient and much more cost effective.